Hey friends, welcome back to my studio. I'm so happy you're here with me today. I'm gonna paint this cute robin. It's on pixels.com. I'll link it in this video's description. I cropped it, so we're gonna zoom in on it. We're gonna paint it on a little 5x5 inch wood panel, and I'm gonna draw. I'm gonna show you some quick little tips for drawing it. Okay, let's have some fun. Hey, let's chat for a second here. So I'm using basically primary colors, Mars Black. They're all Liquitex. Most of them are basics. Titanium White. I like to buy it in the jar because I go through quite a bit of white. Cad Yellow Medium Hue. I buy it in the big tube and basics because I use quite a bit of yellow. For, I think, I want to say every color, but definitely most colors. You need a lot more yellow than the other color because this isn't as strong of a pigment. So that's Cad Yellow. Quinacridone Magenta. And then Phthalo Blue Green Shade. Okay, so a lot of yellow, a little Mars Black makes a great background color that isn't too far off of our reference photo. So that's fun. Might be a little yellower. I put a little black in here. I'm painting a little bit on the sides. Oh, this is a 5x5 inch cradled wood panel from US Art Supply. I have links in this video's description to a lot of the different supplies I use, just in case you're curious. And then I'm also using a 3/4 inch flat brush from Royal & Langnickel. And I'm just getting some paint on. Excuse me, guys. And the wood is showing through, but I don't mind it. It gives it a little bit more of a warm look. But I don't know if you can, you can kind of see the wood grain. So you can tell that that's transparent or semi-transparent. I just wanted to point that out. If you want to have it darker or not transparent, add a little white to it and then come back with more color. You can do it either way. I'm just smearing some of the paint on the sides. So I'm gonna work on this some more. I just wanted to pop in that my colors are, like this one says it's transparent because the box is open. And then this one I'm pretty sure is semi-transparent, which I don't mind at all. But if you want them opaque, add a little white to them, and that'll do the trick. Okay guys, I'm gonna finish this up. Oh, I forgot to say I wrote the word love on it with chalk pastel. And once I get this done, I'm going to do some work, go for a walk, and let it dry really well before we draw our robin on. Okay, guys, I'll be back in a bit. Just a couple of comments. So I printed out my robin to scale, and then I drew a line down the middle horizontal, a line down the middle vertical. So I have marked here 2.5 inches to the middle, 2.5 inches. It's 5 inches. And then I drew with an ink pen so you guys could see it, that there's basically a really nice oval egg shape right here. Oops, where's my... What, it didn't show up right here. Can you see it? Oh, probably because it went in the dark part of the... There. And then I have some marks here, so that's halfway in. So an inch and a quarter, an inch and a quarter. There's actually one right there, an inch and a quarter. So that helps me too, so I have halfway in these lines to help find landmarks. And then I use things like the pencil width. I don't know, do I use a kneaded eraser, my fingers, to help measure. You don't have to be super exact, but just to get things close. For the branch that it's sitting on, it's higher up here and lower down here. I flattened it out. And then I'll carry it over onto the side. What else? Oh, and there is another oval up here, which I didn't really use, but you can see that. This is almost a straight line, the beak. And it lines up just about, oh, hang on, guys. The neighbor's having their grass cut and trimmed, and it kept getting louder and louder. So that's not quite, from the top of this oval, it curves a little bit. But that beak starts about right there. Actually, I have it straight. I could curve it a little bit down if I remember. That might be too long. Oh, this is a white charcoal, General's charcoal pencil. So, I mean, it takes me a lot longer to do this, which is why I use a traceable. It speeds it up for me. It is good practice for helping you see things, find things. Your eye, you get better at judging the distance of things and where things go. And then I just kept finding smaller and smaller details within this oval and this oval. And I think I have the eye. Actually, the eye maybe needs to come a little more forward. I don't know, maybe not. And then this is the orange. I think that pretty much covers drawing it. It helps a lot to give yourself some reference points. I mean, you could, you know, measure the beak is this far up and this far up. It's kind of easy to do the quadrants with a small drawing like this. If you're doing a bigger drawing, you could do a bigger grid. Okay, guys, I'm gonna start, I think, working on the branch, and I'll be back in a bit. Hey friends, just a couple of quick thoughts. So what I'm doing here is I'm using a number one Simply Simmons round and a 3/8 inch. I'm trying to think of that. A lot of times I say the wrong size. It's a little bigger than a quarter inch flat brush from Michaels. It's a number 10 Craft Smart. And I had that egg shape I drew. Now I'm kind of painting the egg shape. I'm keeping that in mind. I put in some white. There isn't a highlight. The light's pretty much coming from the front and left. It's a little darker over here. The bird also might be darker over here, but I don't see any like light coming back. So I think the light's coming from over here. I've got my original little sun that Emily made. And I'm also gonna have some coming at the top because it's lighter up there. And I'm just kind of working out, like there's this shape here. I could actually change it a little bit. I could correct that. It has more of a curve. I just saw that. Sometimes you don't see things until later, but you can come back and fix. I keep my paint on the thinner side just so I don't get ridges. Or it's easier to paint over. Is that right? We'll kind of do that and see if we like that. So I have a warm brown and a cool brown, and I put some white and a little yellow in this one to lighten up to a creamy, which I used here. And then I've got a cooler gray brown. I just put some white in there. And I'm going to put that in now because that kind of goes here. Well, it kind of goes up there. What's nice is birds, flowers, they're not perfect, so you don't have to get them just right. Oh, and I've adjusted the eye. Here, maybe we want a little tour. I took the edge of my, or the handle of my brush. So this printout, I also had on my iPad, but this printout is to scale, even though I drew this. And I realized it's about the width of the end of my brush. So then I made the eye about a width. So hopefully that's in a good spot. And then it's not quite round. I had it round when I drew it. It's kind of like almost a little square on the top, has a little point over there. You don't have to get all that in there. That's just what I'm thinking about. Okay. And then as I was painting this gray area right here, I noticed that it comes pretty close to the eye. So I might need to bring it in just a little more. But I can adjust things as I paint. And you can fix them if you get them wrong. It can be frustrating. I think that kind of comes in. So I'm looking right here. So I'm kind of out of paint. Oop, I grabbed a little water, but I think I grabbed too much water. It kind of comes like this. Ooh, that's a lot of water. I'm not sure what I want to do with that. I think I'll just leave it and let it dry. So brush stroke direction helps you. You don't have to paint every feather, but just paint. I can see, if I get really close, I can see that the little feathers are going this way. Plus, this is a good indication. And then, like, there's some light ones that come up here, but there's also some that go over. You don't have to get super detailed. Just think brush stroke direction, shapes. It can help you. And my values aren't just right, but I'm kind of just getting down the color, this kind of gray-brown color. Yeah, it's looking too dark, but I think that'll be okay because we can... we can lighten up. And then there's some dark bits in here, but I think I'll put those in last since there's not a bunch of them. So this is a little warmer right here, so I just painted the back side of him warmer in general, but then I can come back with some of the gray and do that. One thing nice about the cradled wood panel, oops, hopefully that was in frame, is that it's smoother. I gessoed it, I don't know if I mentioned it, I gessoed it with clear gesso. This is at least the next day. And it's smoother so you can lay your paint down smoother, whereas I do also like the canvas, the gallery wrapped canvas I bought, but you'll feel more drag. I don't know if you can see the canvas texture, maybe if I just kind of, oh, you can a little bit right here. Sometimes it takes just a little more paint. But as you see, sometimes I get too much water and I don't get it right the first time anyway, so you just adjust as you go. Okay. right, I just wanted to pop in. It's starting to take shape, which is fun. And then I will go off reference photo too, just to like cover the background, which I'm doing right now because I'm talking and I'm not really looking at the reference. I like that arch right there. I'm gonna grab a little white. I wanna make sure I get that in, and I'm gonna bring it down just a little too, give it more of a curve. Okay guys, I'm gonna continue to work on this and I'll be back in a bit. What do you think? This is a cute bird. I love painting this robin. I don't have this species of robin where robins where I live. We have the I don't know if they call it the American robin. But this is just adorable. I really like it. I love using the palette knife to get different textures on the wood. I think that's easier. You might like it. I painted on the sides. The bottom's simple. Put a little yellow in there, glaze a little yellow just to warm it up a little bit. You could glaze some orange or browns. I use my gray brown pretty much for the wood. What else? The eye, oh here, let's do a little tour. So the eye, I just kind of had a little orange and browns and just kind of kept playing with the color. And then I put a big black pupil in it. And then I put a bigger sort of gray cream highlight in it. And then I put a white dot. And it's a good tip or trick if you can't see in your reference photo where to put the color in the eye. You put it, so the highlight's up here, put the color below it. Isn't that neat? I think that looks great. I like the little highlight up here at the top. The beak is a triangle. You see the triangle? Isn't that fun? Then there's like a little piece that goes down there. I did not put every line into the wing. I did put a little bit of light color right here at the very end, just to separate it, the tail feathers from the wing. I don't know how many coats of orange I put on. Oh, and then that's a fun, you might like this, a fun little thing is just to pull out a couple of stray feathers. And I kind of have one right here. Now I don't know where we did for the tour here. We'll go like this. I put quite a bit of detail in the feet. I love how big their feet are. And I put a little yellow in the foot too. What else? Oh, if you can't, sometimes it helps to have both the black on the nail and the white. There I just have the black. There I use the black to help pull out the nail. Okay. I lose the edge almost with the background. And then here, since it's dark here and I have the light, I have a lot of contrast here. That's fun. So this dark makes this highlight pop out quite a bit. And then this is light, so that makes this edge pop out a lot more. Whereas this is softer. That's fun to play with. I just played with it as it went along because I already had the background in there. You could also change your background colors or values to make that happen. I think that's about it. Let me know what you think in the comments. I super appreciate your friendship. It means the world to me, and it's been a lot of fun. Thank you for all your support. Great big happy art hugs, and I hope to chat with you soon. Bye, guys.